One is after this session, you should know about the basics of Kotlin, like basic syntax, how the things are. And second, you should know about how to set what Android Studio is, and you should be able to build your first app as well. Last, I will be directing you to the resources so you can learn further as well after this session. So let's start. So let's start with the with some history. So Kotlin was the first stable release of Kotlin was in 2016, and after only 2 or 3 years, in 2019, Google announced that Kotlin will be the preferred language for developing Android apps. Okay, so why Google announced that that Kotlin will be the once again. First, let me tell you about what Kotlin is. So Kotlin is a statically typed object-oriented programming language, and it also support. So let me tell you about these terms separately, so you get a clear idea of what actually Kotlin is. So first of one is statically typed. So like programming languages are of two types, statically typed, and second one is dynamically typed. So statically typed, so languages like C, C++, Java are statically typed, where we have to give types to the variables or define the types of return type of a function or give the types to the parameters and all in the program. Okay, so at compile time, the compiler should know about every type of the variables and all. And but in dynamically typed languages like Python and JavaScript, you need not to give types at like when you are declaring the variables, but also the interpreter, because interpreter is smart enough to know what the type of the variable is by its value. Statically typed in that construct, but you cannot say Kotlin is like completely statically typed. You have to give it a value. Kotlin comes between both of them, because sometimes in Kotlin you can get away without giving type to a variable, and we will you when we actually code. And second one is object oriented programming language. So Kotlin like supports the concept of classes and objects. You can create classes and objects from it in Kotlin. Okay, and it also supports functional programming. That means you can create functions and you can like call it wherever you want. So this is not like Java where you have to write classes for everything. So do you have any questions like on statically typed or object oriented or anything on that? Do you have any questions?
No, sure.
Okay. So the next question is why should we use Kotlin over Java, which is being used before Kotlin? So reasons you should choose Kotlin over Java, and I have listed some of them. First of one is like Kotlin was developed keeping developers in mind, and what I mean by it was like code is really verbose and you have to write lot of code for doing simple things, but in Kotlin the code is really precise and you don't have to like write much code for doing like simple arithmetics and all. You can like get away with writing small amount of code. If you have ever worked with Python, and you can do like much amount of work in small number of codes, and the Kotlin is in that way, is like that way only, like similar to Kotlin. And as I said, the code is precise, so there are less chances of you making any mistake while coding. Also, this is the point I mentioned before as well. Companies nowadays prefer Kotlin for Android development over Java. So if you want to like make a career in the field, you need to have the knowledge of Kotlin. Okay. Let me show you an example. So here is an example. Like this is, we are like doing some work in Java, and we are creating some classes and and this much for which this much code is required. But if you see Kotlin, for doing the same thing, we need to write only one line of code. So you can like get an idea of how precise, how short Kotlin is as compared to Java. So what next? So enough talk, and I think I should like give you like hands-on on how to write Kotlin. Okay.
So let us,
okay. So best place to learn any programming language is its docs. So you can check out the docs after the session, and the docs are like quite fun. You can let me tell you why. So if you come here to the docs, you can see docs are the Kotlin docs are quite, and you can, if you're learning something like you're learning how to print a statement, you can actually run the piece of code here, also edit it. Okay, you can also edit it here and run it here as well. Okay, so you can see that is quite interactive, and this is not the only place to where you can write Kotlin. Okay, for this session we will be writing code in this playground provided by only, but there is a IDE as well where you can write Kotlin, and that IDE is developed by JetBrains, and JetBrains is the same company which like created Kotlin. So let's start with some formalities of learning a new language, and that is by printing a hello world. From here you can run the code, get the output hello world. Okay, so there is one more way to where how by which you can print the statement, and that is you can use print. But with print you don't get a new line after the statement sends. With print line you get one, like if with print line you get a new line after the statement sends, like you can see here. Okay, so first let me tell you about the function, what this function main is. So function main is like a entry point of the application of a Kotlin file. So if you have ever worked with C++ in your previous semester, you would have seen function void main or int main. So it kind of similar. Okay, let's start with some basic stuff like variables. So there are two ways to define a variable in Kotlin. This val with which you can create a variable like int. While creating variable, first we give the keyword val, and then name of the variable, then type of the variable, and then its value. Need not to give semicolon after every line of code, so that is also quite good in Kotlin. And you can create age. Okay, so val is used to define constant values. So once you initialize it with a value, you cannot change it. So about val, value cannot be reassigned once you like initialize it. So the another way to define variables is var, and so you can like change the you defined with var later in the code. Okay, so let me do this, and you can see here we have changed, got the output. Okay, so as I told you, Kotlin before, like Kotlin is not an entirely statically typed language. So what did I mean by it? So If we remove this ink from here, let's check if it's still working or not. So it is still working. So the concept behind it is type inferencing. Happening here is Kotlin is inferencing the type of age by its value. So this behavior is kind of similar to the dynamically typed languages, but the difference like here is you cannot do something like this. You just defined the variable but didn't give its name type, or you also didn't initialize it. So let's see what happens in this case. So you will get an error saying like the variable must either be type annotated or should be initialized. You have to give it a value that we saw in the previous case, or if you don't want to initialize the value also and use it and give it a value later in the code, you can do something like this, like declare a value and give it a type but not initialize it, and later in the code you can initialize it or give it a value and then use it wherever you want. Okay, so that's how you in Kotlin. Also, there is this one thing I want to tell you about. If you want to like level variable on which you want to like which you want to be con like if you want to declare a variable at the top and you want it to be constant and use it in the code later, you cannot do that. Is like if you are declaring a top level variable, you have to be initialize it, okay, with some value, and you cannot get away with it if you declare a top level variable. Okay, so this is all I want to tell you about variables in Kotlin. Question related to anything like type inferencing or what is statically typed or anything, you can ask.
I guess in Kotlin we don't want any semicolon, right? I guess that's not necessary.
Yeah, that is not necessary.
That is interesting.
But if you give one, you will not get any error if you give one, I think. Let's check. So it is your choice if you want to give or not. There is no. Okay. So anything else from anyone? You can questions in the chat as well.
In the chat, we have a question, like compare between Kotlin code versus Java code, which has, which high security, I guess that is what they meant to say. So what would you say regarding?
Okay. So like in Java code is like more prone to there is a very famous error in Java which developers face while coding is null pointer exception. So what happens is you declare a value, and if you don't if you declare a value like integer age and you just give it a type and not give it a value, okay, and you later use it in the code, Java will not show you any error that you should initialize it and then use it, and that because of that we get a lot of error while coding in Java. In Kotlin, if you just declare a value and use it, you will get a error, you will have a warning saying that you should initialize it before using it, so you don't have to wait for like doing all the build and all then seeing the error. But if you use Kotlin, you will get the warning before the application. So that is a quite plus if you are using Kotlin. Okay. So is this clear?
Yes, Keshav.
Okay, so anything else? or can we move to the next topic?
We can move to the next topic, Keshav.
Okay. So now let's talk about some control flow. Okay, so in control flow, if and else is not much different from any other language. Value and you can put simple if else statements and like what do whatever you want to do in the block of code. Like if I give it a check like age, and ln and what else. So that is quite straightforward. The only difference in the control flow of Kotlin and other languages is in other languages we have switch statements, okay, but we don't have a switch statement, but thing, and that is when, and we can use when to do the same thing in Kotlin. We give it a value and provide different checks, like if it is 18, we can do something here. And this is the syntax where we check for the value of age. If it is 18, we will execute this piece of code written here, like we can do something like when it is 18. Okay, and if we like, we can similarly check if the age is 19, we can similarly print it is 19. Okay, and then there is default case in which the value of age is matched to no choice here. And for that, we will give a default case. We can give a default case by statement. This will can put here something like neither 18 nor 19, and it will work fine. Like since the age was neither 18 or 19, this statement is run and we get this output. Okay, and similarly, you can put any numbers of, it will work just fine. Okay, so any questions on that of the on control flow? Hello, guys.
Yes, Keshav, I guess we don't have any. If others can have, they can directly unmute and they can ask. If not, they can put it in the chat box.
Okay, so when is something new that you wouldn't have seen anywhere else? So,
usually we will have a default, right? Here we have else, so that is different. Yeah, that I noticed. And the switch case starts with when, so that was interesting.
Yeah, so like there is not much difference in the functionality, just some syntax. Okay, so now if there is no question, we can move forward.
Yes, Keshav,
okay,
we can move forward.
Okay, so now let's talk about arrays and loops. So we define an array with this keyword. Like we can do something like letters because they are short. We can define an array by this keyword, array of, and give it any value, any number of values like 1, B and C, and we should be able to print it. Okay, so there is some error. So just I should print it with some loop or something. Okay, so let me do this for letter. Letter and letters print. Letter. Okay. So, like, this is how we define an array, and this is how we can like loop through its values. Okay, but if you want to like go through it by indexes, you can also do that. So instead of directly getting the value, we can get the index, and for that we should we can do something like this. This is, and we can get this print ln letter. We are just printing the index here and the value. So here we got the indices and the value at the index 0. Similarly, we can also loop through in this way. So let me show you this. Dot size minus one. Okay, I will be telling you about this. So first let us check the output. Okay, so should give it a zero here. Okay, so what's happening here is being in a range. Okay, so here we are looping through a range, and range have like a starting value, or you can give anything you want. And then there is this two dots which like tells the Kotlin that we are defining a range here. Is this end value where we like give the end value end index. Like here we have given the size of the array. And in other languages, if you have ever worked with range, the last the end value is not inclusive in the range, but in Kotlin it is. So instead of just directly giving by subtracting one, so the size is 3 and the range is 0 to 2, and we are printing that 0, 1, 2 and the value at these places. So this is the range. So do you have any questions on like loops, ranges, or arrays?
Like in array, should we have just the strings, or any other data type can also be mixed?
Yeah, it can be mixed. Like you can also give one there, or like a boolean as well. It should work fine.
Okay. Awesome.
So the range and loops are clear. Also, at many places you will see defining arrays with list of operators like numbers. See something like list of numbers one, two, three. Okay, so the you can also define an array by this syntax, list of, and there is not much difference in the functionality of the array. Only thing is like you cannot modify the list once it is created. You cannot add values, delete values from it. So we use array so that we can like dynamically add or remove values from it. So it depends on the functionality you want. So if you want a list of constant values, modified, you can use list, or if you want dynamic array, you can use array of operator to like create a array. So are there any questions on loops and ranges and arrays?
I guess not, Keshav. I guess we can move on to the next topic.
Okay, so the last thing I want to talk about in Kotlin is functions, how the functions work. Okay, Kotlin, the syntax and all. Let me delete it. So functions are fairly simple. We give some output, run some code on that, and return output. Okay. So let us do this, where result, we are calling a function. Like first we should create a function. Here we can do that. We create function with fun keyword. Here you can do add to something like this. And we take the parameters, number, and we give the type of expected parameters like this, int, and then we give the type of the output which this function is going to return. So we are going to add a 2 here to a number. Output will be a integer only. We can do something like num plus 2. Okay. And now we can call it, call the function. It is add 2 and give it a number. Resolve and store the value in a variable. Result. Okay, and just print the output. So we got the output 4. Okay, also, if your function is not returning anything, you can use something like unit, which basically is like void, like which tells the Kotlin like this function will not return anything, and you can just put the variable here instead. We should print the variable result here only instead of returning it. Into result. Okay, so we got the result here as well. Also, one more thing. If your function is really short and is doing just one thing or returning only one thing, you can do something like this. You can totally omit that return type of the function and just do something like this, and you will get the result as well. So, got the value. So, do that if your function is doing some or doing some just returning something like in one line of code, you can do something like this. Also, you can give default parameters. Okay, so you can do something like num2 equal to 2 and num plus num 2, and if we don't give it a value, let's see what does it print. Okay, so I have to give it a type. Here we got the result. So in this case we can give it a second argument of any whatever value we want to give, and it will add that value instead of the default one. Result. okay, but if we don't give any value, it will use the default value given here. Okay, and one more thing which is you should remember is you have to give the argument in the way like it was mentioned in the function. So if we are expecting a value of type to add or anything like which is a boolean, okay, and so if you give a value here, if you have to give the values in the order they were like mentioned in the function. But if you don't want to do that or you don't know about the order, you can, what you know, what are the values expected, you can also give named argument. You can also use named arguments like num equal to 2, to add equal to true, and num 2 equal to whatever value you want to give. And in that case, the order will not matter and you can use the function. So this is all I wanted to talk about functions. Put it in the docs. Okay, so also if you have any doubts or something, you can ask. No. Hello guys.
Okay, sure.
Do you guys have some doubts regarding functions and all?
No question. No doubts. So far.
Okay. So that is all I wanted to talk about Kotlin. I think you should have a like basic idea of syntax of Kotlin. Read more on. So now let's go to the. So if you have doubts like anything regarding Kotlin, you can ask now. This is your chance. Like you can leave a comment or unmute yourself and talk. If not, we can move to the Android part.
Apart from online, how can we run another Kotlin course in our offline system?
Okay, so you can download this. IDE by JetBrains. As I told, this company is the same company which developed Kotlin. They are known for developing IDEs. They basically create IDE for everything like web development, Python, Kotlin, Java, and this is the created for use Kotlin IntelliJ IDEA. You can also write Java code in it, and you can like install it from here. And the installation is really easy. You just have to click on next, and it will like install and set up everything. Any YouTube videos or blog for setting up the IntelliJ IDEA on your system. Okay. So there is this question, can you tell me about Kotlin types? Which, okay, so basically Kotlin supports all the types like integers, characters, double, float. Okay, let me go to the docs and be able to. It basically supports every type that you see in other languages, like characters, strings, arrays, and everything. It also have like different types of integer types depending on your memory use. Okay, so if you are like storing, you want to like store some small value, you can use byte or short and int. There are several types in integer types as well. Types like float and double, and they are used for storing decimal types, and you can use this depending on the size of the value. And it does have many more You can read it from here. Like it has characters and strings, arrays. In other languages, we have in Kotlin as well. So, anything else, guys?
I guess not, Keshav. I guess we can move on to the next topic.
Okay, so now we are going to talk about Android. So the best place to like on best or only place to write Android code or is Android Studio. Okay, and you can download Android Studio by doing a Google search and coming to this website. You can download the latest version from here, and when you will install the version, then the Android Studio will ask you to download several other things with it, like a virtual device and Android SDK. So you should like, and that will be useful when you write your Android code. Okay, so you can like go through the download here. You can come here and just do this and it will be downloaded. Okay, so not a big task to download it. You can check out videos or like the, you can check out the videos and you will be able to set it up. Take a long time, so I am not like showing you how to install it everything in this session. Okay, so you can install it from here. And so important things in Android are layouts and views. These are the two most important things. Layouts are nothing but the screen or of your device. Okay, and views are the things which you see on your app, like whatever buttons, text, or anything you see on your device, on your app or any app, it is a view. Okay, so in a screen, which we call layout, we have different view groups. View group, this is a view group and this is a view group. And in view group, we have different types of views in it, like image view. Let me show you this. So views are of different types. Any text you see, any image you see, any button you see on your app is a view. So like ever been to your contact app, okay. We have this scrollable list of like thousands of number, that is a scroll view. And you see a name of any contact, that is a text view. You see an icon on the left showing the image of your contact, that is an image view. So everything you see on your app is a view. So that was some basic stuff about Android. Now let's create an Android app. Like in today's session, we will be creating a simple app, and that is a dice roller app. Just click on a button and different dice image will be shown, and you can like, that is quite fun, easy and fun app to start with. Okay, so we will be making that app. So once you successfully install Android Studio, you will be able to see this screen when you open your Android Studio for the first time. And then from here you can go to this play here and create a new project. Also, you can, if you have some existing project or you are like downloading anything from GitHub, to just check out the code, you can use this button to open the project. Creating a new project, you can come here and go do this. Okay, so now to like select an activity. Okay, so activity, what activity is, like if you see an app, there are several screens on the app. So just take the example of contact app again. So we have this first screen where we see all the numbers, and when we click on a number, we go to the details page of that contact. We have basically have two screens on the contact app. So these screens are called activities in the app, like in the Android. So your contact app have has two activities. First one is the which contains all the list of the users, and second activity which contains the details of a single user. Similarly, when you create a new project, Google Android Studio give you choices to select a template for your app. You can choose this basic activity where you get these dots and this plus sign or okay, and as a ready-made template. Also, you can choose this bottom navigation activity. So what happens in this, if you have used Instagram, have a bottom navigation in there as well, where the first one is the home button, then there is explore, then there is like profile page. So when you click on any of it, like it goes to a new screen and you get to see a new activity. So here you will get three ready-made activities, and on clicking on any button, you will go to that activity. Okay, but that activity will be blank. There will be nothing on it, and you have to like build upon that ready-made template you get by choosing this activity. Similarly, there are other activities as well. Like if you want to tap and you want some like activity which have this like ready-made activities for showing ads, you can choose this. If you are thinking of making an app, choose maps, like Zomato or anything, you can choose this activity. Here you will get a main screen and an activity where you can see the graphs, see the maps. Also, then there is this login activity where you will get two activities. First of one will be a blank screen, and you will get a button. From there, you can go to this login activity where like ready-made input fields and buttons will be there. So like this, there are several activities you can choose from. So, okay, but we are choosing this empty activity, which is completely blank, and we will be doing our work in this. So now let's go to the next part. So this is the part where application. So whatever name you want to give to your application, you can write it here like dice roller. Then there is this package name. It is used to give a unique identity to your app on a device. Okay, so if two apps on a device have same name, it is helpful for giving your unique identity to your app. Then there is this location, the location of the app or location of all the files on your device on which you are working. Okay, this language where we select the language in which we are going to code. You can either select Java or Kotlin. And for this session, we will be choosing Kotlin. This minimum SDK. So as you know, Android has different versions. So from here you can choose which versions are you going to support, which versions your app will support. So you can come here and you can see if you choose something like Lollipop, okay, your app will support 98% of Android devices out there. And if you choose something like Pi or Oreo, your app will only run on 78% of Android devices out there. So it is better to choose like this or like KitKat or Lollipop version, which support higher number of. Okay. So for this session, we are choosing KitKat. Now let's finish the build. Okay, so now it is preparing the workspace. Ready? It will take some time. Okay, so just bear with it. So it is loading everything. It is creating the template files. Okay, so it can take time. It totally depends on your like power of your computer, how much time it will take. So So these are the two most important files. First one is this activity main file, and this one is the Kotlin file. So let's let it load, and I will go through all the folders and files and how we can create the Android app. Do you have any questions on Android Studio or anything like you want to talk like on layout or view? We can discuss because it can take time. So if you have anything to ask, you can ask now. Okay, so like it will take some time, so let me tell you about some things here. Okay, it loaded. So when you will install the Android Studio in your device, it will ask you to like download an emulator, which is a virtual device on which you can test your things. You can either download that, or you can like you can use your real device to test your applications. And for that, you have to go to the settings of your phone and enable USB debugging. And when you will connect your laptop with your device, you should be able to see your device over here. As for this session, I have installed a virtual device, so it is showing that virtual device. And if you have not downloaded it, it will show no device here, and you can from here, like if you come to this drop down and you select on this AVD manager, you can download virtual device. And if you want to test your application on iPad or something, like you can select any phone, can download it, and it will show up here once it is downloaded. Okay, so first of all, let me go through all the folders, what they do and what not. So the two main folders here are app and Gradle script. Let me first tell you about Gradle scripts. So Gradle script is a tool which helps us to package our application. So it takes all the code we have written and creates a APK file which we run on the device. Okay, so that is not very important, but that will work with is this file app. Okay, and there are three main folders here. First one is this manifest, and we have this Android manifest.xml. So let's see what is there. So this file contains all the information about your Android app. What is the name of the Android app? What is the icon? Okay, of your application. Does your application need any permission for saving anything or using audio, video? So all the permissions you see while like installing any new app, all the permissions are mentioned over here. Will your required internet for working, and everything you like, every information related to RAB will be defined here. Okay, and you can edit it obviously. After this, we have this Java file, and here we write all the Kotlin, like all the Kotlin related files, where like we use these files to add interactivity to our application. All the button clicks, all the scrolls, all the drag and drop you see on your application, all the code, interactivity related code we write is available in this folder, example.diceroller, files where we write test. Okay, any like you want to write manual test for your application, you can write it here. We have this resources folder, Okay, and we have four folders under this. First of most important one is the layout. So in the layout folder we have activity main.xml. So it contains all the UI related stuff for our application. So since our application now has only one activity, so we have only one XML. So if you want to like add more activities, you can create more XML file here and then connect it to the different Kotlin files and then import the Kotlin files in this main file. Also, there is this folder drawable, like which contains all the images which you will be using in your app. Any image you use in your app, you store it here, okay, in the drawable folder. Mipmap folder, which contains the icons of your app. Okay, so if you have ever like decreased or increased the size of the icons of the app available on your device, so these folders contains the icons in different density pixels densities, so which match the like the size of icons you have set in your device. Okay, so now we have this last folder, which is the value. Here we the colors and the strings we are going to text or the string colors we are going to use in our application. Okay, so suppose you have a button here. Suppose you're using a button in your app and you want to give it a color. Okay, so instead of directly giving a color, you can do that too, but instead of directly giving it a color, you can define your color here and give it your color a name like this, and you can use the color in the file. Okay, and you can hover it to see the color, and you instead of, like as I said, instead of directly using the color, we can use the name by importing the color. Similarly, if you want to like use any text, we are using this text dice roller on the top, so you can use the variable, like you can give this text a string here, dice roller, and give it a string name. And instead of directly using dice roller, you can use app name in your activity main or any other activity you want to use. Helpful because if you like just write the hard coded string, the spelling might be off, okay, but it will not show any error. But if you use app name and you make any mistake over here, the Android Studio will show you an error, so you can get away, like you can minimize the errors you get. So by using values instead of hard coded strings or colors, it is quite useful. Okay, so do you have any question on this file structure over here? Hello, anyone have any questions on the file structure or any file they couldn't understand what is the use of it?
Okay, sure.
So now let's come to this activity main. Okay, so this is where we design the UI of our code. Get a hello world. Also, you can like see the XML code for the same. Okay, and you can design it here, and simultaneously the code will be written here. So if I just remove this by like clicking on the delete button, and this text will be removed, and you see the code. The text view is removed from here. Okay, so whatever you do in the design, it will show up in the code. For you, previously we have different views available in our Android Studio. Some of the common views are text view, button view, image view, scroll view, and switch. also there are other views as well, but we are not using them right now. So you can like explore other views as well. About like common views which we see usually in the app. Okay, then there is this design, and there is this blueprint. So here we design our app, and so we can do something like we can drag and drop here. We can use an image view, image here. Sorry, I've used a text view. Sorry, we can use an image view. It will ask for default placeholder image, and we can give it here. So here you can see the image view, and in the blueprint it is also showing. Like if you in the design part, the views like can somehow like get one over the another, and you cannot see there is a view, and in that case you can use blueprint to see like like if you do something like this button and cover it by image view, like there is this blueprint, like it is, these views are over one another, and there is not much use of this blueprint, but so you can remove it from here. We are just going to keep this design part, and we will be designing our app. So since we are creating a dice loader app, we will need an image view to store the image of the dice, current image of the dice, and a button to dice again. Okay. So here this is the attributes part. Here like we add different attributes to the color, padding, margin and all. And there are a lot of properties you can check out. But like if you want to change the text, you can search here. And you can edit the text from here. Okay. If you add padding, if you want to add padding or something, you can search it from here. You can add padding. You can add padding, chart, left, top, however you want to. Lot of properties you can store, and you can edit from here, and this will show up in the code part like this. So to correctly position our element, we use something like constraint layout, okay, which is helpful for positioning our views according to the screen. Like we can do something like this, constraining it to the left and right, and it is in the middle now. And we can also constrain it from the top. This image will have this position according to top, up, right and left, and just that. And we can also position button as well, okay, like the same way. We can move around it. So if you want to like position anything on your app, you can use constraint view, and it will like work just fine on your. Also give height and width to the image or any component for the matter, but for our image we are giving it a width. So if you want to give it a width, we edit this property layout width and give it a value 200 dp. Here is density pixels is the unit here, okay. And similarly we can 200 dp, Okay, and the size is fixed. Let me just run it again. And one of the most important features for any view is ID. Okay, so like to uniquely identify every view on our layout, we use ID. So we can get the also we can get the views by its ID. We can add event listeners on it, like clicks or drags, what to do if the button is clicked. For that we need to have give a ID to the application, to the view. So we are giving this button ID. You can give ID like whatever you want, and this is saying to this is telling us to reflector the role button role button ID. So if you have ever used the previous ID, it will automatically change every instance of it. You can do this. So anywhere it will see the previous ID, it will change. Similarly, we can do something like dice image. We have given the IDs to both of the views. Also, so we have given the IDs. Also, we want to show different images on the button click. For that, we have to like get the images of the different positions, and we can do that from here, resource manager, and we can click on this plus icon, the drawables. For this, you have to download all the images from internet or whatever, and you can store it on your device. For this session, I have images. Okay, here you can see all the positions. So I will be importing that. Do this, and it will import all the images. From here, you can rename or anything you want, and rename the image. And we are not renaming it, and we have imported all the images, and it will be in the drawables folder. So now we are going to add the functionality to when we click on role button, image should be set here. Okay, so for that we will need to have the ID of the button so that we can add an event listener on it. For that we have to edit some build Gradle file. Okay, so that we get the IDs of active XML files in the Kotlin file. So you can come here in the build Gradle module again here. It helps us to get the IDs of the views in our Kotlin files. And now once you edit it, you have to synchronize the project again. So once that is done, we can use the IDs in our Kotlin file. Now what was the ID? Role button. So it is showing the button ID available in our XML file, and we can use that. Now we will be adding an event listener. So for capturing the clicks, we use this function, set on click listener. And once the click is once user click the button on this view with the ID role button, we want to execute some file, execute some code. We can call a function here, role dice. So Kotlin is showing us an error saying that you have not defined role dice, but you have called it. So it is showing, like telling us to should can I create a function role dice for you, and you can click it. So it will create a function here, private function. So anywhere else in your code you will not be able to, sorry, in other, if you create some other files for Kotlin files for other activities, you will not be able to import this function. So this function is private to this class of main activity. Okay, so before moving on, let me tell you about this main activity. So this is inheriting a compact activity. Okay, so it is a pre-written code class which we are like inheriting, and it gives some APIs, and so that we can use those APIs in here, like set event on click listeners and all, like setting the main layout. Main activity once the app is clicked. So whatever the activity is binded to this main activity, it will be the first activity which will be shown to the users when they click on your app. Okay, so just that. So now we want to replace our image every time the button is clicked. So we have defined this function. We have to get a random number so that we can use something like we will be creating a variable which will hold a random number range 1 to 6. So this is how we like create a range, call a random function here which will like give this variable random number value between the range 1 to 6. Now depending on the number, we will assign image to a variable as variable first we should be able to like declare a variable in which we will be storing the current image. So that we will be using current dice image. We are just declaring it, we are not initializing it. So now we are going to use print statement. Depending on the random number, we will give dice image a value. Okay, so let's use this when random number. So when the random number is 1, we will assign the value of image which has 1 on the top. So we can do something like dice image. So to get the value of image dice image dot 1, we can go to resources dot drawable dot dice image 1. Okay, so but if the number is 2, we can do something like dice image equal to r dot drawable dice image number 2. Similarly, we can do for the other numbers as well, where we check the random number first. What is the spelling is there? Random. Okay. So we can do the similar thing for other numbers as well, where we check the random number and assign the value to the dice image according to that. 4, and we will assign the dice image 4 on the top. Really, we can do that for 5. Uh, random number is not 1 to 5, then definitely it will be 6. So for that case, we will not use a number else, but we will give a default case by using else, and we will assign the dice number 6 to it. So now when we got a random width based on a random number on a button click, now we will replace this image placeholder image with the real image, and for that we need to have the which is dice image, and we will do something like dice image, and for replacing the placeholder we use this function set image resources. So we'll use it, and we will give the new image to it. So I think everything is fine. This is no error. So if this it will also Android will also show you some modifications you can do. It is saying that we can use val here since we are not changing the value of random numbers once it is assigned. So if you want to change, you can do. I am going to change it. Okay, so if you have created and like if you have connected your real device to the Android your PC, it will show your device, and once you run the app from here, the app will directly run on your application on your device. But since I am using an emulator, it is in the emulator, so we are going to run the run this app on the emulator. So just run it. Now the Gradle build process has started. Take time for the first build, but subsequently when you are going to make changes in the app, it will take lesser time. Check the build process from here, what the Android Studio is doing. Okay, writing up APK. Okay, so it can take time, so just make use of that time and ask question if you have any question like related to Android Studio or virtual device or anything, you can ask in the chat or unmute yourself to talk. If you have any difficulty or any doubt in the code itself, you can ask that too. Hello.
Yes, Keshav, I guess we don't have any questions. So I'll just drop in the feedback link for today's session. So whoever has joined, you can fill it up so that we can send you a certificate of participation. Can we use?
Okay, so I don't think you can use VS Code for Android development. This is the only place you can use. Okay. So. This is the data from the previous app, so it is still running. Okay. So app before, and I ran it on this emulator, so it is showing that app only. Sometimes like it is still building, and it will create another app for us. So kind of ignore it for now.
Thank you.
Okay, some random question I'll ask. Like, which is the Android version which you like, Keshav?
Okay, so and there are no particular version, like everything works just fine.
Okay,
There are no particulars. Yeah.
Okay, what about you guys in the meeting? Like, I can drop in your favorite Android version in the chat, or you can unmute and tell us.
Hi
So
Keshav,
guys,
this is Amo. So this question, you can even answer it in the end. So this is something like, now everyone is going behind Flutter and other frameworks, right? Because it's much convenient and it has a lot of flexible components. So how is Kotlin better than Flutter, or what do you suggest? So this Kotlin and the traditional way of them.
Okay, so let me answer it. In Flutter, you have components, you build, you make widgets. No. So similarly, Google has launched Jetpack. It launched Jetpack, which is set of libraries to make Android applications like Retrofit or something, which are used to fetch data. Similarly, it has launched a library called Jetpack Compose, which is very similar to Flutter, and you can create widgets and all in the Android as well. Okay, so when we were creating a new project, you would have seen a activity with polygon. So the polygon was the sign of Jetpack Compose. So now Android is also coming up with the widgets and all. Like, you can do pretty much what you do in Flutter in Android as well. So it is catching up as well.
Okay, cool. Android. Yeah. Okay.
Build is fine, and we should be able to run our code, run our app on the emulator. So folder for now, and when we click on the role, we are able to see a new image. And so when we click again, there is a different image. So you can click how many times you want, and there will be a random image. Click on it. There is an event. Okay, event is fired, and this role dies is executed, and every time it is executed, it is generating a random number between 1 to 6 to random number, and depending on that we are giving this dice image of image from our Drupal, and setting up the placeholder, changing the placeholder image, previous image with the new image. It's really simple, and you can check it here. Okay, so the Android app is also complete. So if you have any questions, I have Android 11, but I don't know. Hello guys, did you see the app which we made? It is working fine. So if you have any queries or any question, you can ask. Can we move to the next part?
I guess we don't have any questions, so we'll move on to the next part, Keshav.
Okay, so now we have the basic understanding of Kotlin and basic understanding of Android, like layouts and click listeners, what are events and all, how we design app, everything. So from where we can learn more. Okay, so let me tell you about how to move forward with that knowledge. Okay, so there is this course, Android Basics in Kotlin, developed by Kotlin and Google team. will teach you everything about you need to like know for a junior developer for of Android. Sorry, this course has like 6 units covering each topic, and once you like complete. Okay, so there are 6 units. First of one is like Kotlin basics. It will cover particularly about it will be particularly about Kotlin, covering everything like else, classes, object, conditionals. Okay, so it will cover that part. Then there is layouts. It will cover the design part of your application. This unit, like what is material design, what are layouts, and how what are the best practices for developing UI in Android. Unit 3, where you will be like getting to know about navigation, how to navigate between different activity on button clicks or bottom navigation or any type of navigation. You will learn it here. Okay, it will contain the information about internet, like how can you fetch data from internet and store like show that in your app. You will be using libraries for fetching images and all. Okay, so the library which you will be using in this unit will be Coil libraries as well. Now then you will be in unit 5 you will be taught about data persistence, like how to store data in your app, like once like using an internet and you are filling some form and all, and if the internet is like off, then how to persist that data, how to store that data in your device for the time being, and you will get to know about that. And in the next last unit you will get to know about Android Jetpacks library, in which in this part you will get to learn about how to handle background task, like if you are building some audio application, okay, and you have like removed the activity in from the history, so how can you like keep playing the audio when the activities your app's activity is not there, or if you are downloading something from internet, how to like keep downloading it once the app is closed. Okay, so you will get to know about these things in this unit. So each unit have some pathways, like this first unit have 4 pathways, and each pathways has some activities. Okay, and like video, like you will get to learn from videos, and then you can come here and do a code lab as well. Okay, where you will be writing hands-on code. Okay, you can go to a code lab, get out, you can like complete, you can read, you can like in the other pathway you will be able to write code as well. Okay, so this is the basic stuff they are teaching here in this unit, in this code lab. Like in other units, in advanced unit, you will be able to write code in the code lab and see these videos and like learn. And at the end of each pathway, you will have a quiz. And if you get certain, there is a certain passing mark, which you will get. Certain passing mark, and if you are able to get that, you will get a badge, and that badge will be developer's profile. So Google provides a developer profile. Okay, so I have got course and pathways and take a quiz. So once you have completed a quiz and you got a badge, you can that badge will be automatically on your developer's profile, and if you complete this course you will be able to get 16 badges. Okay, so this is basically the because every screen thing here is like up, really updated. Okay, so you don't have to go through videos covering topics which are not useful now. Everything here is up to the mark, and you can learn everything about Kotlin and Android from here, from this course. And this is totally free. You don't have to pay for anything. Okay. And this course will help you to, like, for the, if you want to take Android developer certification exams of Google in passing that. So every, okay, so that's all I want to tell you about the course, Android course. Any questions about the course and all, you can ask.
Any perks of, you know, earning all this?
So there is a deadline, like, if you, so we have like conducted this session late because of our exams, but there was a deadline of 5 January, I think. If you complete all these labs and if you are able to submit an application certificate from Google, and that you have completed all these units and you have submitted a application as well, and you will get 80% off for your exam from your exam fees when you will go for this exam. Certificate is really valuable, this Associate Android Developer certification, and for that you will get 80% off if you complete all these units before and get all the badges. Okay, and you will get a certificate as well from Google for completing all the units. And the, like, best perk that you will get is like is the knowledge after completing the course. The most valuable thing you can get out of it. So any more questions you guys have, you can like write it in the chat or unmute yourself and talk.
Like, all the slides have been covered, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So okay, like, whoever is there in the call, like, if possible, you can, you know, turn on your camera so that we can just take a screenshot of as a proof that we have conducted the event. So, like, follow, you can stop your screen share, Keshav. Like, you just turn on the cameras and take one quick snapshot.
Okay. Thank you guys once again for attending this session.
It's just that there are some relatives at home, that's why I won't mute. Just a minute, I'll be back. I guess no one turned on. Okay, fine. One more announcement is, like, we are starting with the recruitment for our next batch. So keep, you know, your eyes on our Instagram and join in our Discord servers for more updates. And if you have any queries regarding your recruitment and all those stuff, you can ask us now. Like, we are all here. The core team is here, so you can ask us. I guess it was Dharanesh who applied, you know, who messaged us in the community platform. Dharanesh, let me just check it once. Yeah, it's me. Like, do you have any questions regarding the recruitment or like, I would like to know from which year you are, Dharaneshwaran, second year or third year? Second year, okay, awesome. So yeah, we'll be starting the recruitment soon. I hope you have joined our Discord server. If not, I'll share the invite link and you can, you know, keep yourself posted regarding the updates.
Also, guys, there is one more thing. If you have any questions regarding Android or Kotlin, you can directly ping me on the Discord, and I will really happy to answer your queries.
What is the selection process? Well, for normal membership recruitment, you will be, you know, filling a form, and based on your form input, it will be shortlisting you guys for, you know, as a club member. And if you are there for around 1 or 2 years, and based on your active, you know, participation in our events or, you know, club related activities, you can, you know, apply for the core team next year. So based on that, we will again shortlist for the core team. So if you're interested, make sure to be, you know, active and, sorry about that. Yeah, make sure to be active in our, you know, server, ask questions, be interactive. Like, that is what we expect, and learn new stuff. That's also there. Any other questions? Again, we turned on the camera. Okay, Keshav is here. Anagraha, Navina, Deepthi, Hariram, Dinesh, Dharaneshwar. Just one quick snapshot, man. Like, Aditya is here. You can also turn on your camera, Aditya. Like, if you're comfortable. Again, that's also there. If you're not comfortable, it's fine. Okay. Getting calls can be interesting. Awesome. Yeah, I'm just taking a quick snapshot. Yeah. Oh, we have Krishna over here. Hi, Ramesh. It's been a long time.
Hello, bro.
What are you up to these days? Learning Flutter or design?
Learning Flutter.
Acha.
Awesome. Yeah.
So yeah, I have taken this snapshot. Thank you for switching on your camera. Thank you, guys. We'll end the call for today, and thank you for joining the session. Whoever has filled the feedback form will receive the certificate. Thank you all for joining. Have a nice day.
Thank you, guys. Have a nice day. Bye.
Yeah, thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.